Good morning, Father. Good morning, Jesus. Good morning, Holy Spirit. Good morning, family. Here we are, another day. This is day 26 of our A Proverbs a Day Keeps Distractions Away journey. How are you guys doing this morning? Praise God, praise God. Let me go ahead and share this on my other walls. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Good Sunday morning to you. Let me see. Share to a page. All right, here. God is so faithful. I'm telling you, God is so faithful. Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you for this day. We thank you for waking us up this morning. We thank you for life. We thank you, Father God, that today we're going to experience you in a supernatural way. We thank you, Father, that you are here by your Spirit. We thank you, Father God, for just being who you are. You are the God who loves us beyond measure. And we love you just the same. In Jesus' name, amen. Good morning. Good morning. This morning, we are going to Proverbs chapter 26. Verse 27. And this is what it says. Whoever digs a pit will fall into it. And he who rolls a stone would have it roll back on him. One of the greatest insights that I have when it comes to the word of God is this right here. Is that all humans came from one human. So that means when I see that reality, that means that whatever I do to someone, I am really doing it to myself. And this scripture says that if you dig a pit, you will fall into the very thing that you dig. And God is so much about his people that he wants us all to know and understand that we are all connected. The person in Africa, even though I don't know that individual, that's my brother. The female in Spain, even though I don't know her, that's my sister. We are all connected. And life is to be lived from this viewpoint. I believe the golden rule is this, right? The golden rule is that we should treat others the way we desire to be treated, okay? Would you like someone to dig a hole for you to fall into? Probably not. So that means that you should not dig a hole for someone else to fall into. And if we live life from that viewpoint, believe it or not, living life from that viewpoint, we will fulfill the entire gospel. We will fulfill the entire gospel because we will treat others the way we desire to be treated. When we want to plot and scheme and do things that aren't right in the eyes of God, we are really doing it to ourselves because the way God structured life, the way God structured the earth, you don't do something wrong and get right back in return. Come on, talk to me this morning. Say wisdom. Say wisdom. You don't do something wrong and get right back in return. Remember, every seed produces after its own time, right? So if you do something wrong, then you're going to get that back in return, right? So if nothing else, you don't want to do anything out of the way because you don't want the harvest of the seed that you sown. Come on. Come on, am I talking right early this morning? You don't want the harvest of the seed that you have sown. So don't dig a hole for someone. Don't roll a stone where someone would be injured because you're digging a hole for yourself and the stone will roll back on you. I live life this way. I always think about this. How would I feel if that was me? How would I feel if that happened to me? How would I feel if I was put in that position? So that keeps me in check because I don't want anything to come back to me. I understand that once I release a seed, I understand that once I put it, the seed in the ground, then the law is working at that point. There's nothing I can do to stop the harvest. So you can predict your harvest by the seed that you sow. Somebody say wisdom this morning. That's good. You can predict your harvest by the seed that you sow. you can predict the outcome of something that you do. Because the Bible tells us that every seed produces after his own kind. And the truth is that when God made Adam, all humans came from that one person. He did not go back to the soil to make another human. All humans came out of that one human. How would life be for you? How would life change if you saw life that way? If you saw it from this viewpoint, when I hurt her, I'm hurting me. When I hurt him, I'm hurting me. If you saw life from that viewpoint, how would it change? How would your actions be? How would your decision-making be if you knew that you were hurting someone, but in all reality, you're hurting yourself? How would that change? And I believe that life should be lived that way, where we see ourselves in other people. Why is that? Because God sees himself in us. Somebody say wisdom. God sees himself in us so that we should see ourselves in him, but also see him in other people. You got it? God sees himself in us. We should see ourselves in him, and we should see him in other people. Therefore, our actions should reflect us seeing God, even though that person may be ungodly, even though that person may not be acting the right way. If you view life from this standpoint, what you have done is you have safeguarded and protected yourself, because you don't want to dig a hole for someone based on what this proverb says. Because digging a hole for someone, you are really digging a hole for yourself. Whoever digs a pit will fall into it. And he who rolls the stone would have it roll back on him. My God. We have to really change our focus, change how we see things, and understand that all humans, I want to drive this home this morning, all humans came from one human. When you impact one person, you impact everybody. When Adam sinned, it impacted all humanity. Everybody sinned when he sinned. When Jesus delivered us, we all got delivered. When Jesus delivered us, everyone got delivered, because the first Adam brought us to sin. The second Adam got us out of sin. Praise God. Father, I gave you a truth this morning. I gave you a wisdom, and I thank you, Father God, for insights to reality that all humans have came from one human. And I pray, Father God, that we would see a difference as you see. Fix our spiritual eyes so that we can see from that viewpoint, that when we bless one human, we are blessing all humans. And when we curse one human, we are cursing all humans. Help us, oh God. Help us change our focus, Father God, to what your focus is. In Jesus' name, amen. Guys, thank you for joining me early this morning. I am about to get ready for service, so I'm going to see you guys at 10:10. Okay, guys, God bless you. Hopefully, you would have an amazing Sunday, and hopefully, I'll be seeing you guys in 2 hours. Talk to you guys later. Peace.